We live in an era where people are very specialized, and physicists fall into these two categories, the theorists and the experimentalists.
I should mention that I started graduate school thinking that I'll be a theorist, but then somehow I started doing experiments and I realized that I like playing with toys.
The people who do experiment, they like building things in general, and the people who do theory, they like math and they like theories and like models.
Yeah, we like dwarves and they're the elves, you know, of Middle Earth. They're out there in the skies and we're down and digging through the dirt and the rocks.
Theorists often try and think about not just the way the world is, but the way the world could be. Experimentalists, their job is to go out and figure out which of these ideas is actually right.
A great example is Einstein, who just kind of said, here is general relativity, here is what it predicts. And then decades and decades later, we are still testing that theory over and over again.
The famous physicists, for the most part, who get all the glory are usually the theorists, Albert Einstein, Richard Feynman, Isaac Newton.
I don't know why there are no famous experimentalists. Maybe because we're more modest.
It's true that experiment looks to theory to decide what things are interesting to study, but theory is often now waiting for experiment. For instance, LIGO, there were 40 years between when they first developed the prototype when they finally discovered gravity waves. That's a long time.
The problem is, of course, that a theorist has the luxury of coming out with 20 different theories. It's very cheap, it's very fast. We work a lot slower because building something and troubleshooting it and getting it to work, we are bound by laws of nature, whereas theorists are not. They could just invent laws of nature.
The experimentalists like to play up this rivalry more than the theorists do because I think they know they're going to win it.
We don't let theorists into our lab, mostly because as soon as a theorist walks into the lab, everything stops working. So we try to have a no theorist sign on the door.
For the most part, I think theorists understand that we really need the experimentalists, and without them, we have no idea what we're doing.
It's a friendly feud, and we're well aware that we do not exist apart from each other. We need each other, and we need to communicate to each other. And if anything, we probably should do that more.